स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज अबाउट काइनेमेटिक्स एंड इट इज आवर यूनिट नंबर टू. नाउ वी हैव टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. द नेम ऑफ यूनिट टू इज काइनेमेटिक्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डिफाइन दिस टर्म. व्हाट इज काइनेमेटिक्स? रिमेंबर दिस थिंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड. Kinematics mean motion. First of all, you need to know the meaning of this word. Kinematics mean motion. So it is the branch of physics, or you can also say it is the study of motion of the objects without discussing the cause of motion. So when you have to define it, you should keep in mind this fact that it is the study of motion of objects. I have not written here of objects. You can write it is the study of motion of objects without discussing the cause of motion. So two things you have to keep in mind: study of motion without discussing the causes of motion of the objects. So that branch of physics is called kinematics. So this topic is about of unit 2 about kinematics. Okay, so now let me explain to you a bit. If you consider the definitions, the thing become clear to you. We have to study only the motion of the objects, not the causes. Causes mean, for example, we study the motion of a moving car. Car is moving on a straight line, or car is moving in a curved path, or car can be move in circular path. But we will not discuss the cause. What thing is compelling? What thing is forcing the car to move? So that we will not consider in this topic. Only we discuss the cause and types. So that is our kinematics. Okay, now next topic is rest and motion. You can see second topic, rest and motion. So these are also very easy to define, rest and motion. In generally we say rest mean the body which is taking rest, which is not moving, the body that is not moving. In general term, we say that it is in rest, but it is not a definition. The physicists, the scientists will not correct you this definition. You have to describe the complete. You have to define it completely. What is meant by rest? So when you define rest, you define it like this: a body is said to be at rest if it does not change its position with respect to its surrounding. If it does not change its position. I will write shortly. Does not change its position. Does not change its position with respect to its surrounding. With respect to its surroundings. Okay. Now it is also very easy to understand the meaning of this definition. In rest, the body is said to be at rest if it does not, I have written briefly, if the body does not change its position with respect to its surrounding. Surrounding mean in which situation he is living, like its surrounding. Like I am standing here, my surrounding is like this whiteboard, my surrounding is like that wall. So this surrounding. If I am at rest, I will not change my position. I will stay at where I am. So then I will be called at rest according to this definition. If I start changing my position like this, so then I am changing my position with respect to board. I am changing my position with respect to wall. So then that type of motion is known as motion. Then we define the next term, motion. So many examples you can give here. Like at rest, example, e.g. for example, like a bus standing at a bus stand. A bus standing at a bus stop. Many examples you can give. A bus standing at a bus stop, or you can also say a train standing at the railway station. If the train is standing at a railway station, not moving with respect to its surroundings, so then that train is also be in a rest position. So in this way you can quote many examples from your daily life. Okay, now next term is motion. Motion is also very easy to describe. Opposite of this rest is motion. You can also say opposite of rest is motion. But you have to describe, you have to define completely. A body is said to be in motion if it changes its position. Now you will skip this word, not changing. In motion, you have to write, a body is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to its surrounding. If the body changes its position with respect to its surrounding, then that body is called in motion. You can also give many examples from your daily life in motion. Like if the train is changing its position with respect to the passengers standing at the railway station, then that train is called in motion. If the train is changing its position with respect to the passengers standing at the railway station, then that train is said to be in motion. So in this way you can quote, you can give many examples from your daily life. Like I am changing my position, like moving, changing my position with respect to whiteboard, with respect to wall, so I am in motion. So in this way you can give many examples from your daily life. So this topic is so simple and so easy. So I think the concept is clear to you now of both these topics, rest and motion. First of all, you have to define rest, give examples, then define motion and give examples. Then topic become your the topic is completed. Okay, but sometimes there is a relative motion. What is that relative motion? Sometimes it happens that a body has two kinds of motion, also rest and also motion. So that kind of motion is known as relative motion, when the body has two kinds of motion. For example, passengers sitting in a bus or the passengers sitting in a train, if they are at rest with respect to their fellow passengers because they are sitting at their seats, they are not changing their position. So that's why those passengers are at rest with respect to their surroundings, mean with respect to their fellow passengers. But if somebody is observing from outside, if the body is observing from outside these passengers, then these passengers are in motion because with respect to surrounding, with respect to outsiders, the persons who are observing the passengers sitting in the bus from outside, then those passengers are in motion. So it means that kind of motion is known as relative motion. So I think this concept is also clear to you, what is meant by relative motion. Okay students, next topic is types of motion. Types of motion. You see that many objects in the universe are in motion. So we have divided this motion into three categories. One is known as transitory motion. Okay, so keep in mind that transitory motion contains further three categories. Mean linear motion, it is L, linear motion, and then random motion, and then circular motion. Okay, so keep in mind transitory motion contains further three kinds of motion. There can be three kinds of motion in this transitory motion. Linear motion is also termed as transitory motion. Random motion is also termed as transitory motion. Circular motion is also category of transitory motion. Okay, next is rotatory motion. And then comes vibratory motion. So these are three categories of motion which we study. ओके, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू अबाउट दिस ब्रीफली. ट्रांजिटिव मोशन. ट्रांजिटिव मोशन मीन द मोशन ऑफ सम ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. द मोशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विदाउट रोटेशन. दैट मोशन मे बी इन अ कर्व बट देर विल नॉट बी एनी रोटेशन. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ मोशन इज नोन एज ट्रांजिटिव मोशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द मोशन ऑफ अ कार मूविंग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. मोशन ऑफ ए कार मूविंग इन अ स्ट्रेट रोड और द मोशन ऑफ ए कार मूविंग इन अ स्लोपी स्लोपी प्लेस लाइक सम काइंड ऑफ अ हिल. दैट इज ऑल्सो कम इन फॉर्म ऑफ ट्रांजिटिव मोशन. ट्रांजिटिव मोशन मीन द स्ट्रेट लाइन मोशन, द स्ट्रेट लाइन मोशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट विदाउट रोटेशन. स्ट्रेट लाइन मोशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट विदाउट रोटेशन. बट नोटिस दैट दैट स्ट्रेट लाइन मे बी कर्व. सो दैट्स वाई दिस काइंड ऑफ मोशन इज नोन एज ट्रांजिटिव मोशन. सो लाइक लीनियर मोशन. Linear means the straight line. Linear means straight line motion. Straight line motion of the object is called linear motion. If the object is moving on a straight line, like a straight road, car is moving a straight road, that is a kind of linear motion. Random motion means the motion, random mean irregular motion, irregular kind of motion. That motion in which there is no regularity, so that kind of motion is known as random motion. For example, motion of the smoke particles, motion of the birds, motion of the birds, or motion of the straw, motion of the straw, motion of the smoke particles are kinds of random motion. Or motion of some insects, that is also kind of random motion. Now third is circular motion. As the name is telling to you, the motion of the object along the circular path, the motion of the object along the circular path, that kind of motion is known as circular motion. Like motion of our earth is also kind of circular motion. And the motion of a toy train moving on a track, circular track, that is also kind of circular motion. In this way you can also give many examples of circular motion. Okay, now come next, rotatory motion. Okay, pause.